WhatsApp, aku Anlin, selamat datang ke another episode of Korek Physical. Hari ini aku bersama
Aman Ra.
Yeah, so hari ini macam biasa kita akan sembang-sembang music and then after that Aman will korek all the physical releases dekat Teenage Head Records SS14 Subang Jaya. Okay Aman, yes, what's sir. New with you?
Now just promoting Fighter. This is for the film Sangkar, my second OST. Lepas tu also baru je release my song from my album Rebel, Brother, featuring No Saleh and Ultimate. And then now working tengah cari material for my next album.
So any apa macam any differences meaning in the sense of how you're working on the second album ke you're following the same route as the first one?
No, this time what we're trying to do is not do it the same way. Based on this one principle, what got us here won't get us there.
Okay.
So we're just trying to add variety in the mix. I'm trying to grow as an artist as well. At this point of time, I'm trying to be the most stupid one in the room, so that I learn and absorb, so that hopefully the follow-up songs, people like it.
Any particular producers that you call kerja?
Yeah. Second album ni, I'm working with Navigator full on. So Navigator and I are going to just write and orchestrate and plan and execute this second album sonically. And then from there, also I will be working with other people. But it's very much I work with you, this part, just us. And then other parts of the album, just us. So it's different than Rebel. We worked with a few. I worked with a few people. So this one is just me and Navin going back and forth lah. So this time it's now he will say ni tak boleh, ni boleh, and when apa dia kata boleh, maybe I'm like ni bukan Aman Ra sangat kot. And he has his idea what Aman Ra should be like. I have my idea what Aman Ra should be like. So we're trying to meet in the middle and really marinate that part.
Lyrically,
I'm not quite sure if I need to dial it up or not. I've had my macam I want to be a lyricist face. And I want to now see macam kita nak cara penulisan tu nak pro MC ke, pro budak flat ke, atau do I want to make it pro Aman ke, you know? Me and Navin, Navigator, we're going back and forth about that lah. But we already have a big picture. So it's a kesinambungan daripada Rebel. But cara tu kita tak nak buat cara yang sama lah.
Do you put a deadline to yourself?
We're looking at to finalize all material by this year. But of course, we have the deadline. But if you know work is not done, then work is not done. We have to continue working lah.
The transition from Craft to Aman Ra, what was the turning point?
The turning point would be like everything was not working for me the way I wanted it to work. For some reason, I felt like the key is me. I cannot find the key. The key is me. So I need to sharpen this key, make it a master key. It boleh buka all this mangga, which is like cabaran ke apa. So I thought like it's better I start off with to define who I am, okay? So Craft was superficial. It's manufactured. It's not even a name that is mine, okay? And then along the way, I learned all a man has is his name. And my mom called me Aman, A-M-A-N. And a lot of things was not working because I was a boy. And a lot of things will work when I become a man. So it's A-M-A-N, space, and you become a man. I was like, wow, wordplay, enlightenment ke apa semua. So I said, we're going to run with that. Then I learned about a little bit of, everybody kept talking about like, you know, Greek history, that's where real man came from, or ancient Egyptian. So when I was going through ancient Egyptian, then I found this guy called Amun Ra. So he's Amun Ra, kings of kings, wow. And then something caught on to me. He's the savior of the poor. And I was reading this in Keramat and like, you know, life was like that for me. And I'm like, poor, wow. So it just, you know, like I went like, I think I'm going to put Aman Ra. So I just marinated on it. So when I wanted to change, so then I go back into like, okay, I've done inner dialogue, now let's do outer dialogue. Kan? And I'm talking to, hey, I'm thinking of this, what you think? Bro, jangan bro, dah bertahun kau kerja sebagai craft, nanti kau nak takkan you wanna, woo-woo. Jangan bro, woo-woo. Buat bro. So I'm just taking all of this, inner dialogue back again. Ambil engineer buang yang keruh, right? Then I said, Aman Ra it is. To conclude, I think I have learned this. Now I shall apply this, and it looks like this. I think this is the most elaborated answer I've given to the craft Aman Ra situation. Also, I would say it's a bit funny that whatever I was looking for was there all this while.
Cool. Kita akan sembang banyak lagi dengan Aman lepas ni. So Aman, the yes, first album yang beli album apa?
Marshall Mathers LP, Eminem.
Kenapa kau nak beli album?
Dia punya lagu The Way I Am, that just sus. I felt he wrote the song for me, you know. That album solidified that behind the scene or in front of the scene, or whether they know me, they don't know me, I will listen to rap till I die. That rhythm, that frequency, that's for me. You know, like other genres pun nice, beautiful music, but when it's rap, then I feel like athlete. Mungkin dia basketball player, first sport basketball player. Tapi dia, because dia athletic, dia boleh main banyak benda. But the moment dia main basketball tu, dia boleh rasa satu semua aligned. So I felt that about rap.
The first local hip hop album yang kau beli?
Plan B, Too Fat. I had a cousin and he was always rapping. So he played Boogie Down. So I felt like it was very fun. Very not Marshall Mathers LP kan. So I was like, okay, this is dope. And then I would try to put the Marshall Mathers LP lah. So you couldn't dance to that song. It's more of like it's far the element of rap. This is just rap. I don't rap here for you to dance. Nah, it's none of that, you know. I came from macam jatuh hati dengan rap from that department. My friends jatuh hati with hip hop from I wanna do all that kind of stuff. And I was like, they Melayu, they rapping, sounds so international. You get that, you know, wow. Kita boleh keluar, yeah. So then based on these two butter, I start building.
So the one album yang macam made you want to make music?
Jay-Z, Reasonable Doubt. For me, when I go through that album, it's you fall in love with Cocky. Very can-do attitude, I got that from there. There was a phase, I was just listening to it over and over and over and over and over and over again. That album really made me want to like, aku rasa benda ni boleh kot.
Lepas ni kita akan biar Aman untuk mengorek all the physical releases kat sini. Kita tengok apa hasil korekan dia.
You know, this is one of the first ones I heard this name, Atmosphere. I don't know what the name of the song is, but that bar, man. Everybody says life's a bitch, but she's not a bitch. She's a beautiful princess. You only call her a bitch because you failed to sweet talk the pussy. That line, macam, that time I was like, what is this? Apa cara penulisan ni? I'm very into that kind of stuff, right? Then I learned that's called a metaphor. Oh, Cypress Hill, bro. You know, I don't know. I didn't dig into Cypress a lot. But when I was growing up, when I told you about the Eminem and everything, I had like all these abang-abang around me. They were into that Chicano thing, man. Nico pun rock the checkered shit movement. Luda, Red Light District. This is very nostalgic. When he came out, was when I was trying to be. Anytime got a verse for you. Oh. Dulu lama tau to write a verse. This one, I know Run DMC. After Eminem, I went to Run DMC for a while. I used to take pride in knowing like first album, second album. Because at that time, knowledge kau pun. You know, like you have to know at least the basics, you know. A lot of people sample this Peter Piper, My Adidas, It's Tricky, Walk This Way, Raising Hell, Hit It Run. Run was the man. Like I got exposed to like freestyle a little bit because Eminem was a freestyler, and then Run, the man. I never got to be around when he was popping off. But he's the man. I noticed a lot of California rap artists.
He was one of the pioneers of gangster rap.
This guy. When he was doing it, this guy is around.
Mos Def.
Mos Def, Talib Kweli, you know, like he came from like a pot, like kitchen dia tu semua all great stuff. I think they came from an era where by default, if you ain't got bars, you got no business opening your mouth. I come from like that circle where that was being advocated. Barang tak cantik dia mah. But there was a way of quality control lah, you know. So I think he came from an even extreme. You really have to, you know, be on your game to either speak or get involved in the Cypher's couple. But everyone likes this one, this album. To me, this is, I think, more mature album. For me, because musically, he gets more mature, but like, rap-wise, it's Reasonable Doubt for me. Like, Reasonable Doubt was just, As usual, I go for the hip-hop stuff. We got Havoc here. We got Malik here. This one here, I remember listening to this also a lot. I remembered when this album came out, I felt like Malaysia is not going to be the same. Awan Mendong, man. It was all his name. I feel that way. That was what the I don't know if people felt that. I was just like, okay. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, till 20, it's reserved.
Yeah.
The best you get is 21, bro. Yeah. You know what I mean? Yeah. Sampai kat majlis tu, tuan nak duduk depan. No, depan semua dah reserved, bro. Who? And then only one guy sitting down there. You know what I'm saying? It felt that way, you know?
When it came out, right? Dia sama macam, you know back then when the indie bands, right? Semua nak nyanyi English.
Faham.
So, tak nak nyanyi Malay. Sebab, first maybe old standard. Satu maybe sebab it's hard to you know to sing in Malay.
Faham.
Especially band ini sebab dia orang takut kalau dia orang nyanyi in Malay right. Nanti bunyi macam jiwa rock kapak semua. So the first band dalam tu I think OAG was the first. Yang macam this shit.
Right.
Pak dia keluar Opera Radio Friendly. This album same impact.
What I felt was this is rap.
Yes.
This is not pantun putting on a 4x4 bar beat, you know.
Yeah.
This is like rap. I remember there was one line that stick out was aku macam CD terbalik tak boleh main.
Yes.
You know what I mean? And that is such a rap line.
Yes.
I think this album was definitely when it came out 6 out of 5. And then what makes me even more like to me this is part of my like my journey, you know, like oh because like when we're talking about Public Enemy, I wasn't there when it was happening. It's all reviews, right?
Yeah.
Revisits because of reviews.
Yeah.
And I remember before it was even this CD came out, we had like 3 songs that was being syndicated like through MSN Messenger, Yahoo Messenger, you know, Assalamualaikum. Let me test my mental. Assalamualaikum came out. Yeah. Kau Yang Punya came out. Mantra Beradu Without M. Nasir came out.
Even OK.
OK. OK, the non-remix version came out. But I remember the ones that really made everyone flip was Assalamualaikum and Kau Yang Punya. Because Kau Yang Punya was so... Okay, aku sayang kau. Okay, I was with her, but what we doing right now? We gonna argue or we gonna grab lunch? Pimp means bapa ayam,
yeah.
But in the hip hop culture, pimp is like mamat ni the man's man. Ada ni kegemaran your grandma till your daughter loves this guy. You know what I mean? One of those Johnny Bravo kind of feel, yes. You know? Of course, like from a technical point of view, I was appreciating all the way you park it. The Maltese was there. The wordplay was there, the cadence was there, the enunciation was there, the attitude was there, all of that, rap-wise. It had all the ingredients of what rap culture is, but very Melayu. But then when Havoc came out, I was like, what the f*** is going on? You remember at one point in time we had like, let's get a famous singer on the chorus and rap on it, may radio play it and let's become stars. Underground was banging boom bap because we real like that. You know what I mean? This is at least how I was looking at things.
Yeah.
And then when this Havoc comes out, trickle down effect is everyone now like thinks being relevant is probably the way to go. At one point of time, coping mechanism was being real was the way to go. Macam, the more real I am, maybe we can talk. But when Havoc happens, I felt like there was a paradigm shift where people thought like, I think it's time to be relevant. Good. Being relevant, it's an extension of being real because it shows adaptability. My favorite all-time verse from Joe is Baik, first verse. Every time I see him perform that verse, I'm like, that's a superstar right there. He goes like style ku seratus. He starts that and he ends with korang semua paparazzi. You know when you have a friend that can talk shit and you just love him?
Yeah.
Because he can prove it over and over again.
Yes.
So when Joe came through with that Havoc album, that was what it was. So Havoc just went from the shelves to the billboard in a very defined manner. So yeah, this is definitely 2 albums. For me at least, I learned a lot from.
Yeah, just now I saw something.
All right.
Yeah. I think not many people know about this.
They don't. This is like a long time ago kind of thing.
Biggest learning from this album?
You cannot use blind confidence all the way, lah. There's a lot of ingredients to make something happen. When I did this, I thought I was going to be a millionaire. So I thought recording this was the final destination. And now make me a millionaire, please. You know, I really was caught up in that cycle because I truly, truly believe like this is like we're gonna make it. Tiket tu kita dah ada, bus tu dah nak sampai, gua dah nak naik bus ni. Gua dah nak pergi kat destinasi seterusnya. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But that's not the case. Oh, by the way, this is no cover before Kanye West did no cover.
Yep.
Just so you know. Just so you know. But shout out to my man LZ, dia yang cakap. I was going through the cover process and then I'm like, yo, cover ni nak buat macam mana? Bro, kalau kau gentle lah. And others, I don't know, was it Mos Def ke? Was it Mos Def? I forgot. He told me, diorang keluar macam tu je, baik. The moment when I saw that, it felt very statement-like tau. Cover tak payah, barang angkat pergi, duit buat sini. Because it amplified that. Yeah, and that was my current mood, right? Yeah. So whatever that would communicate that, I want. Kan, like, barang ni bagus, cover ni semua tak cerita, lu ambil je ni. May your life change. Kind of like kind of belief yang I trying to tube into this product, kan?
Ada satu lagu dalam ni, nama tajuk lagu ni Syair. Dia dengan Elvira Arul, right? Hmm. Yeah. Pada aku, lagu tu is the what's the word?
The seed.
Yeah.
With all due respect, I almost forgot about this. When I was doing this Shine, and I felt like, okay, you got a rap from inside, kot. How do I tell you my story? Like, struggle gua sebenarnya nak makan benda sedap je. It's not like gua kena tembak, gua kena tikam, man. You know, you know what I mean? So it sounds non-glamorous, tau. Macam tu je hasil kau. Kau nak makan benda yang sedap. You know what I mean? But how do you put that across and then you love it? I remember who made that beat. It was Techmatic. A lot of people pinpointed, like, among all the songs, Shine was like the chip. Like, kita tengah susun, eh? Tiba-tiba that one thing that dropped, that thing is actually the thing yang will start building, you know? And it took me years to, like, oh, shit. Ni, yeah. I think at that point of time, I expected, like, Ace High or... I didn't look at Shine at all. Like, I couldn't see Yaman Ra at that point of time either. Honestly, if you and I were talking, I would have taken it off the album if you wanted to take it off the album. Like, it was one of those songs, like, you decide. Tak payah lah kot, tak payah it is. You know, it was one of those songs yang I didn't think much of. I gave it everything, but I was just like, now time to decide. Okay, yang ni aku nak, ni. Padahal tak hit pun kan, aku nak ni kan. So, Shine was just, I can't decide. You decide? Aku pun tak boleh decide. Flip a coin lah. So if the coin says don't, no, then we take it off lah. So no one will ever hear it.
That song, kalau korang, sebab aku dah check, memang tak ada dekat YouTube, tak ada dekat mana-mana. So good luck in finding
maybe
it.
Maybe I can sell this to you guys. I find a few copies lah. We park here 100 ke maybe.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
150 if you want it. This is what you call by hustling, my man.
Yep, so ni dah dia hasil korekan Aman Ra, Michael Jackson of the Wall, the one that got away, and then Tupac Greatest Hits.
Yes, sir.
Okay, man, thank you so much for your time. Thank it was a
much.
Pleasure.
Thank you
Looking
much.
Forward to the new album.
Thank you.
Till the next episode. Ciao.
Oh, yeah.